legend 20 to 30 years ago brought Commedia to us. They came and went as of a storm. We do not know them. Their names are lost to us, but they brought Commedia here. We do not know them, and lo, they were here. They brought Commedia. There was Commedia on these lands. And then E. Sebastiani came. Dun, dun. They were here!
Of Arlecchino of La Mancha! Pinocchio.
Oh, yes, Master Orazio.
I have recently had a strong feeling that it's been difficult for me to sing out loud, and we've been so close, and we've been friends for so long, and but then it's so hard to open up one's heart, especially for us Italian.
Any help in expressing this deep feeling?
Oh, that's why I'm here, Master. You always have some difficulty with expressing your feelings.
Yes.
And those feelings, you need to let them out. You need to expose those feelings so that they can grow and prosper.
You're right, but it's so hard when you know someone, you get close, and it's just, I cannot hold it back anymore.
Yes.
Yes, the beautiful lady Isabella. Her dress is flowing in the latest fashion. Her beautiful shoes. Oh, so amazing.
Yes, the lovely lady Isabella.
Yes, who did you think I was talking about?
Well, she's the only one left in town.
Oh no! Has it been that many this week?
Yes, Master, it has been quite
a few. Oh, no. I better not mess this one up.
Right, so how about we work on your delivery a little?
Yes.
And you can never go wrong with a letter.
Ah,
so I'll help you write that letter.
Okay. And dresses and shoes.
Dresses and shoes are fine as always.
Go on.
Yes, it is I, Pantaloni, the richest man in all Ravenna, and I have finally finalized the contract to marry off my daughter Isabella. It is a wonderful day. I have a family of daughters, and they are lovely, and I will be getting rid of them one at a time. And then I won't have to pay for their dresses and their shoes and jewelry and all. But that's a wonderful thing. So I must tell Isabella. Isabella! Isabella!
Oh,
Papa. Oh, there you are, Isabella. I have wonderful news for you.
Wonderful news!
Yes, I have finalized the contract. You are going to be married to a respectable man of power, prestige, and standing.
Well, man with power, he who needs to be exciting and have a nice, clean-shaven face so I can just nuzzle against him.
Well, he will be. He is a man of an upstanding citizen of the community. He is knowledgeable. He is reputable. He is my friend, Dottore Graziano. He's perfect!
Dottore Graziano?
Yes, I know. I needed to pick a man that I was familiar with, for I can't have my lovely daughter marry just any man off the street. I mean, he could be a penniless pout, or an axe murderer, or a Spaniard! Oh!
How can you sell or enslave her to Dottore?
enslaving her. Yeah, Dottori is a learned man. He's a humanist. He's not a slave driver.
Unlike you.
You, go help. Go help your mistress.
You who make me clean your bathwater once a month. You who always call me Nespola. And you who never even pay me.
Oh, I don't pay servants out of matter, of course.
You are a horrible man.
I am not. You need to go tend your mistress. But what is it about women?
I heard Isabella crying, and in between the sobs, I heard the word marriage. Are we finally getting married? Am I going to have a man on my own? A beautiful, strong, noble man?
Lavinia, when did you get here?
Just now. I was wondering, do you have a man in store for me?
You know your sister Isabella is going to be married, right?
Well, yes, but what about me?
You should go help your sister. She's going to get married soon.
But
she needs help picking out her dress.
But it's always about Isabella. What? Why do you hate me, Mama? I hate you. You're the worst Mama ever. You let Mr. Mintz eat my goldfish.
Said you were old and boring.
What?
I'd marry you if you were the last.
Oh, no.
you're mistaking it. She's praising me in rhetoric. You see, you're old, stable, you know, established. Boring, okay. The same.
Yeah. I see.
Well,
I don't think she doesn't see it that way. It's not.
Sir, surely you, most learned man, have something in your library that would help change her mind.
Help change her? Why can't you command her? Can't you master your a girl? A commander of fleets?
I have money, women not so much.
So we must change her, or change me, or change nature's nature. The natural texts. Bookshelf 3. Down a little, the blue volumes. Pliny. Pliny the Elder. He's a bit old for marriage. Pliny the Younger. He just had his bar mitzvah. He's not much. Ah, Pliny the middle-aged and desperate. Oh, there was some. Oh, Recto 43.
The blue potion.
The blue potion. Oh, the blue potion. That could work. That would render any man into the hero of 1,000 romances. I'll be very interesting to
him.
Oh, yes, yes.
This sounds very promising.
It's a complicated recipe. It starts with liquor of oyster. Always start subtly.
Oh, yes.
And then it proceeds with the woody stalk of asparagus.
Oh.
And finishes with a bull charge of rhino.
Ooh.
That should do it.
Yeah. So you think this will work?
You'll see a miraculous transformation in her attitude.
Oh, well, by all means. Let us go discuss.
Ah, yeah. Come this way to my library.
I'll believe it when I see it.
Oh, all the better. I'm so glad I hired you. You really are just the best servant in all of Ravenna.
Thank you, Laura.
You're smart, and you're clever, and loyal. Now, how is it going trying to get some sort of infiltration into Pantalone's house?
Team Omega is not going very, very well. Everybody in there is either far too stupid or too intelligent for me to get in.
Yes, those servants are quite intelligent, but that Arlecchino is questionable. So, well, that project we can put on hold for a little while. We need to work on a new one. I've had 26 husbands so far. Number 27 needs to be Dottore. I'm very interested in his little blue potion. Vittoria's whorehouse is alive with rumor about that little blue potion. You and I might go there for a night off one day. So he has to be my next husband. But Pantalone and Dottore are moving forward on marrying Pantalone's daughter Isabella to Dottore. And I just have to put a stop to it because Dottore must be mine. So I can put a little potion.
Well, let's go through our plans then.
So, Plan Alpha is relatively simple, except we need someone to replace the Genoese sailor.
So the next idiot that comes into town.
Right, we can replace him with the Genoese sailor.
All right.
So we need to have a backup plan. So Plan Beta, that one's going to really to require some of those leeches from the ball. How are we doing on that?
We'll get those by the end of the week.
End of the week. Excellent. So the final plan, we have for the backup. That's going to be Plan Gamma. How are we doing with that? Mm-hmm.
Well, Brigella is still in the Spola's basement. I'm not too sure how I'm going to get him out.
Well, we'll have to resort to bribery, and that's all right, but we're going to have a backup to backup, and I don't want to spend any money I don't have to. So we're going to try Plan Alpha. We'll see how that goes. And, some sort of patsy comes along. It's Ravenna, anyways.
Ravenna's full of all the idiots. All we need is some Spaniard to come to town.
That's bound to happen sometime.
Ah, Ravenna, finally! Such a long walk from La Mancha. I had to leave home. It's all I have left. My neighbor, fan of the chivalric romances, he read my memoir. He tried to do all of those wonderful deeds that I have done. The great Capitano Spavento, the scourge of France, the hero of Spain, the slayer of 1,000 Turks. Don't forget the hope, it's very important. So he tried to climb all of the mountains that I climbed. He tried to ford all of those streams that I forded. He even tried to chase the rainbows that were on shore. He tried to bask in my splendor and was burned by the sun. So now I come seeking my fortunes and hope to find an investor so I can rebuild my windmills. He thought they were monsters. He was insane. All I have left is my rare artifacts. I don't even have a servant in. Nespola! What are you doing here? You abandoned me when I lost everything. Give me that back. You'll break it. You left me.
I didn't leave you. You left us. You left that young Lepanto. You left all of us. I won't leave you. I'm going and following my master everywhere.
I'm not totally destitute after all. Not only do I have my wonderful rare artifacts, I now have a handsy servant. Nespola. We come seeking an investor. The Dona Livia, a widow many times over, has a bit of the money left. Hopefully, she'll be interested in investing in Dutch technology. Livia!
Yes, this is Mistress Livia's house. Can I help you?
I come to seek your mistress for a business opportunity.
Let me get her. Mistress Livia! Yeah.
Yes, who is it?
There's a Spaniard at the door.
Oh. A Spaniard!
Klein Alpha, in go.
Hello! Oh, so, you seem to be new in town, sir. Who are you?
Why, I am the great Capitano Spavento, the scourge of France, the hero of Spain.
Slayer of a thousand Turks!
Don't forget me.
I haven't heard of you, really. What brings you to our fair town of Ravenna?
I come with an investment opportunity. I have need of investors to rebuild my windmills.
Rebuilding windmills!
And I have also a career of fine relics.
Fine relics! Indeed. Oh, lovely!
Perhaps you'd be interested?
Oh, that's so great! Excellent! Oh, the Dutch! I just adore the Dutch! They're so adorable with their fish and buckets.
See?
Absolutely. Well, I tell you, my investment funds are all tied up right now. Oh, sir, sir. However, I have good news. My good neighbor and friend, Pantalone, just happens to be looking for windmill investments right now.
He even sounds rich.
Of course he does. He's Pantalone famous. And he happens to have a lovely daughter of marriageable age who loves beards. Oh. And yes, she's very into beards and loves them.
Oh,
yes.
Yes.
Exactly.
And I have been a bachelor for much too long.
Oh, of course you have. With your looks, who could resist someone like you when you show up like that with your beard and your bucket?
I am well acquainted with the ways of love and merchandise.
Yes, and it's such a helpful servant. Who could resist this? Oh, excellent! Capitano, please, I would love to write you a letter of introduction to my good friend Pantalone.
Oh,
and I'm sure he would be excellent, an excellent choice for you for investment and possibly marriage to Isabella. Let's just set that up right now. I'll write you a letter of introduction and we'll get this moving right away.
Things are looking up.
Isabella this and Isabella that, and I was all about Isabella. I'm so sick of hearing about Isabella. What about Flaminia? I just want a man. Is that so wrong? Is it wrong to want a man to hold you and please you and just be there for you always?
Miss Fuller, I need a man.
I need Arlecchino.
Miss Fuller, I need a man.
I just need him.
Miss Fuller, I need a man!
I need you like all of me!
Papa won't pay any attention to me. How am I supposed to get a man if my father won't give me one? Are you serious?
Of course you are.
Yeah.
I have an idea.
Oh,
spell is written.
Nobody can prove I did that. And besides, she drools in her sleep. It would just go right out.
So, mistress, what we need to be focusing on then is finding you a man.
You're right. Yeah. You're right, Miss Fuller. I am an independent woman who doesn't need her father to find a man.
So we'll take a map of Ravenna, and we'll take a pin, and we'll put the
pin. Oh, that would take far too much time. We have to leave immediately.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, Arlecchino, what are you doing here? Oh my goodness! Oh, Miss Fall! Arlecchino!
Oh, Flaminia, I have the most wonderful news for you!
Oh my goodness, tell me the news!
Nespola's here!
I already knew that! Arlecchino! Is that all the news you had for me?
Oh no, your father's planning a wonderful wedding!
A wedding? Oh, maybe I'll finally get a man too! Maybe he has someone who will meet me at the wedding, and I'll finally have someone who cares only about Flaminia! Arlecchino!
Yes,
whose wedding is it?
It's Isabella's wedding!
Isabella! I'm so sick about hearing Isabella! Oh, I can't even believe she's a real person! She's so frustrating! I just hate her so much! She's not even that pretty!
Oh, my sweet cream puff, did she hurt you terribly? I hope not.
Oh, no. Nobody could hurt me with you here, Nespola.
Oh, Arlecchino. I wish someday that we could get married.
Oh, I love you so much. You are like the nuts in my baklava.
You're like the honey that tops my baklava.
Oh,
since you both are here, why don't we help plan the wedding?
Yes.
Miss Fuller, Arlecchino. Miss Fuller, why don't you clean for me? Okay, that's enough. Let's go.
Ah! Oh!
like that. We can be.
Yes, I bless this marriage.
Yay! What's the best day of my life?
Well, we must begin talking about the wedding immediately. I love your dress already.
Oh, thank you.
And all in stars and pretty eyes too.
Yeah, yeah.
It's working perfectly.
I still
can't believe how well that motion works.
Master Catalan, I have a letter of introduction for you.
Oh, I don't have time for that. What? Just go in and give it to one of the servants. Woo! Such a glorious day it has become. It started good, and then it went bad. And now it's good again! It's wonderful! Now, what was I going to do?
Pantalone!
Ah! Such a wonderful...
Mwah! Mwah!
So, I'm sure you know who this is, a hero of a thousand romances.
That's a hero of a thousand romances?
Yes, see? Of course! I'm sure you read the letter.
Isabella! Isabella, get back in here! Isabella!
I love dancing around in circles!
But you are an imposter!
No, I'm
you not. Are an imposter!
I'm
you, this is not the what? Right wedding! Come, I would please remove my blessing from you! This is your future husband!
No!
Yes!
Oh, he's hideous! Oh, he looks boring!
Through the miracle of applied academics, the bridegroom stands right.
For what purpose?
I do want to see it.
Okay. Benedetta!
Yes, Master Pantalone?
There is somebody here to see you.
Hello, Benedetta.
Hello,
I have a letter for Isabella. Would you take the word to her? My sweet.
And this is only Isabella. Oh, Pinocchio, lovely to see you.
You're just so... Oh,
Benedetta. Oh, Pinocchio. I'll see you soon. Please, soon. What are you still doing here?
Well, I understand you're upset.
I'm upset?
Oh, goodness. Okay, like, let me go.
Better here.
So, same as mine. You keep saying that nobody likes you. You even don't even like yourself now, right?
Yes!
Yes, yes! And along with that, they don't like you for a reason.
Well?
It's a very good reason.
A good reason?
Yes, you have built yourself up. And anyone who builds themselves up and succeeds, such as you have, how many ships do you have now? 25? 40? 550? 50?
Well, a lot.
A lot. Many more, a lot. Got it.
Yeah.
So, in order to do that, you had to, you know, step on some people, right?
Yes. Yes.
I think you stepped on me once. I didn't like it very much either.
Yes, that's just true. Why I had to do that.
Ooh. I know the time when someone says nice things.
You do?
I read an obituary the other day.
An obituary?
Yes. Mr. Vecchiano, he's just a rotten man, he was.
Oh, well, yeah, that's true.
Very rotten.
That is true. He was almost as bad as me.
And when I read his obituary, I almost didn't know who it was because it sounded so lovely. They said such wonderful things about him.
They did?
Yes, so they only say good things when you're dead.
Oh, they do, don't they?
They do. Mm-hmm. You could have...
Oh, interesting. I think I'll just show you out. I didn't put
he's
no Arlecchino.
But I do believe that I might be able to find a home for this with my mistress, and if she gets interested enough, maybe I can spend more time with my Arlecchino.
You are almost as devious and as manipulative as I am. No wonder we're such good friends.
Farewell.
Bye.
Oh, hello. Oh, Nespol, I'm so sad. I literally looked everywhere and I couldn't find any men. It's almost like this is a town full of women. It's no wonder we're so smart. We're just gonna have to leave immediately.
Mistress.
We gotta go. We gotta. I can't.
But I have something for you.
A present? Wait, was it Isabella's first?
No.
A new present!
So, what would you say if I tell you that I found a man for you?
Oh, a man!
A man that's full of adventure.
Adventure man!
A man that speaks many languages.
Ooh, linguist man!
A man that's well-traveled.
Ooh, a traveled man!
I would like to present to you the letter from your future husband.
Yay! Oh my goodness! He is very good with his words.
Oh yes.
I'm going to have to write him a response immediately.
But make sure you don't sign it.
Oh, you're right!
If your father caught you, and he would immediately look at it and say, this isn't from Isabella.
Oh, that's really smart. Nothing could possibly end poorly by me not signing this letter. Here you go, Miss Fuller. Remember! You have my future husband in your hands.
This isn't Arlecchino.
I can't believe I have my hands on Dottori's junk again.
It's just trash! It's trash! It should just be thrown away.
You know, you're right. This should all be thrown away. Except this fish. This would make a good dinner tonight.
No, you can't eat that fish!
Why not?
It's been to school!
but you're right, this junk, oh right, we shouldn't eat the fish. This junk can be thrown out.
Thank you, I will take it to the dumpster right away!
The music of the Sears is cyclic. Aren't they wonderful, Arlecchino? Have you ever seen such treasure so amassed? Look at thee. The mirror pattern of Saint Sebastian. It blocked the arrow meant for his heart. If he had 17 more like it, he might be here today. Is it?
The swordfish that needs no sword. A man invincible with it.
Is it? Oh, a bonus! A well, I'm sure it's important. Yes. Oh, wait. This is junk. How did he get in here? And here, the mind shield of Archimedes. With this on his head, he was able to stand throughout the Battle of Carthage without doing anything practical. Imagine the power once contained in here. I should trust these only to the best of servants, but you're here. So take care of him. Pantaloni will be my... Oh!
Don't worry! Don't worry!
Yes! I thought you fixed it! What?
Yes! I need you to write me an obituary.
An obituary?
Yes, write my obituary.
Pantaloni, we are old, but you're not that old. You probably have weeks yet to live.
I still need an obituary right away!
Right away! Right away, my friend!
I'm fine!
Steph knocking at your door?
No. I want you to write an obituary because I want people to think that I'm dead so they will say nice things about me.
Yes, but, you know, as your attorney, if you lie to people, and then they make contracts based on lies, they can sue you for lying.
That's why you're my lawyer. You can phrase things just right.
We'll figure it out.
line. I've been so lonely too. It's been a whole half day since we last spoke to each other.
Oh, it's true. You're like the apple of my heart.
Oh, you are like the stars in my moon. Oh, yes, a moon pie.
Oh, I love moon pies.
Oh, yes. Oh, I don't know what I could do without you. I love you so much, Nespola. Oh,
Arlecchino, don't say things like that. I love you so much, too, but you know I can't get married. Flaminia wouldn't be happy.
Oh, no. What can we do about that?
We can try to get her married, and then maybe she'll let me get married, and we can be together.
Oh, all we have to do is find her a man.
We need to find me a man.
You, how about you? All right, I found a man for Flaminia.
No, we need to find me a man. I need Capitano.
Oh, how do we find a Capitano?
Capitano!
Did somebody say Capitano?
I'm the Capitano.
Capitano. I have a letter here for you.
A letter
from a beautiful woman. In fact, she is the most beautiful woman in the entire world. And she's smart and funny. And I think you're going to very much like her.
My. Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Such beautiful poetry. Oh, she wants to meet me at the Fountains of Mercury at noon. But it's not signed. It could be from Isabella. It could be from anybody. Fox Squirrel, hold that. Tell me who sailed this!
Oh, isn't that wonderful, Nespola, the most beautiful, the most intelligent, the most wonderful woman in all the world just gave Capitano a letter from the most beautiful, intelligent, and wonderful woman in all the world. Oh, no!
She must have hurt Capitano's reputation.
Oh, no!
He's supposed to be the best lover in all of Europe!
Oh, no! How can this be? Nespola is in love with Capitano? Oh, no, that's terrible. We have
to do something about this. I can write a letter. I know how to make the letter K.
What is going on in here?
Well, Nespola gave Capitano a letter from the most beautiful woman in all the world, and Nespola is the most beautiful woman in all the world, so it must have been from her, and everything's in that letter, but I can't read it.
I know that this is not from Nespola, but he's such an idiot. Oh, this is going to be so much fun. Oh, it's looking here like they're going to go back to Spain together, and then they're going to go to France.
Oh, no! France! There are terrible cooks in France.
And then they're going to hang out with the Normans.
Oh, no, it's even worse.
And then they're going to come back to Italy, and they're going to eat all the food.
Oh, no, they'll eat all the food after going through the Normans. No! What can we do about this? We have to do something!
You have to fight, of course!
I will fight! How do I fight a Spaniard?
You fight dirty!
Oh, I have a great idea! I just cleaned the privies this morning!
Not what I meant! No, you need to take this junk!
Oh, no, that's not junk! Dottori, explain! Well, this is junk. Dottori, explain! These are magic items!
Oh, yes, I see now. This is the magical piece of armor worn by one of the sultans, loved by all the women in his harem.
Oh, I know where this goes. This covers your most important part.
You have your gauntlet of protection.
I know how to use this.
Your helm of invisibility.
Oh, everyone's invisible!
And of course, your most important part, your pike. I will teach you how to fight. We're off to a great start. I need you to bend your knees. Forward! Straighten your backs! Right arm up! Other right! Now put your pike in a place of power! And
used in a funeral repartee. How do you write a eulogy for Pantalone?
What can I say? I'll start with a platitude.
Here lies Pantalone.
Ooh, that's good.
He always was lying.
Hello.
Do you know anything about writing obituaries?
No, I usually just cause them.
Oh. Would you need counsel?
I don't get caught. And I never will.
Point taken! Available, my hourly rates are reasonable, so. Oh, but still, this business of Pantalone.
Are you Dottore Graziano? Yes.
I am.
I have a letter for you from an admirer.
An admirer?
An admirer.
It's not some business thing.
No.
Not some sham deal.
No.
Nothing about windmills.
No, it's fine.
Oh, love letter. Okay, it starts the way they all do. Usual seamless blue metaphors. That's a nice one. Synecdoche? Nobody uses synecdoche. Who wrote this?
Just an admirer.
Oh, but a very learned admirer. Metonymy? This is the highest form of poetry. I like it a lot. Can you tell me who wrote this? Is it from Isabella? Has she had a change of heart?
I don't know who wrote it. I just think that you better listen to the letter and go where it says to go.
Meet me by the Fountain of Mercury, emissary of the gods. I gotta go.
This is great. Thank you.
I can't believe Pantalone's dead! This is almost as good as when that library burned down in Alexandria! Ah, Isabella!
Oh!
I hate you!
I hate you too, Flaminia!
No, I hated you first! I get to do something first, damn it!
Oh! You have never been nice to me my whole life! When I had Mr. Bennett's the king, you hit him, and you told me he was dead!
Only because he ate my goldfish, which Father didn't replace because, Isabella needs a cat more than you need a friend!
Oh, there's a time I was getting my beauty rest, and you tried to burn down my room with me in it!
Nobody can prove I did that! But if I did, it's because I need to keep warm at night because you had all the blankets!
You had no blankets because all the blankets I made for her, you stole and shred into pieces.
The blankets you made, you handed me all the fabric and told me to make them, so if she wants to tear them up, it's fine, because I was the one that made them.
That's why they fell apart so easy.
Oh. My name's Benedetta. I have strong hair, and I would like to work it all.
Sundial says it's almost noon. Oh, she should be here any moment.
I
I hope it was Isabella. She was lovely. So radiant. She obviously loved my beard.
I float on the wings of Morpheus, buoyed by learned letters. Here I may find my love. Whoever could craft this. Oh, who is it? Could it be Don Olivia?
Isabella? Capitano?
Dottore!
Hello. What brings you here today?
What? I am meeting a secret admirer, but the letter, it was quite well written. Could have been him? Dottore?
Oh, yes.
I like you, but not like that. Maybe once in college, but...
Phi Beta Gamma?
Indeed.
You! I have come to challenge you to a duel for Best Bola!
A duel? No!
No, I clean up after the fight!
No! What? You were trying to steal this ball from me, and I will have to spite you!
Solution does appear in itself.
Espola! Espola! Espola!
You're not Espola! Wait! Aha!
The solution. You! Wait, I've heard of this man. He is a mighty warrior.
Who?
Smote that dirty Spaniard who came to town.
Ah!
This would be a completely different approach. You, sir, the mighty warrior who smote that Spaniard, would you do me this honor and go to Master Pantalone and plead with your might and intimidate him and make him see the truth of destiny that his daughter, Isabella, must marry me?
Yes, I can do this! For my name!
Yes, who are you?
Oh, my name is...
Yes. Is that Welsh?
Oh, I am Arlecchino!
Oh, that's most definitely Italian. Okay, great. Well, then let us begin. This issue would work.
I will make sure that Isabella marries you, stranger.
Yes, exactly.
Do you even know who he is?
Of course I have.
On yonder hill there stands a creature. Who she is I do not know. I will court her for her beauty.
Would you have
she
me
not change my mind? Oh, no, John, no, John, no, John, no. Oh, hark, I hear the church bells ringing. Will you come and be my wife? Or, dear lady, have you settled to live single all your life? Oh, no, John, no, John, no, John, no.
Harry Morton, you must never lose your hat.
Don't lose your hat.
Isabella!
Isabella?
Isabella, I am here to marry you! To him! The famous Bella!
Oh, well, this is a great day. Oh, have you heard the news? Oh, my dearly departed father.
What about your father?
Oh, Papa, he has died. He is no longer part of this world.
Oh.
But he was a really gracious, generous Papa. He always bought me every dress I ever wanted. And I'm sure that he would want me to marry my one and true love.
Oh.
No! Wait, the fish speaks! The fish says your father knows about this!
Oh,
no!
Yes.
No,
yes.
He says he knows!
His soul will never be at rest until all this unfinished business is taken care of!
Oh, Isabella, I found you! Wonderful! I'm getting married!
Oh.
And we're gonna take my dowry and rebuild windmills in Spain!
No!
Find some use for that little potion of yours.
Oh! Dottore, you must tell them! You must tell them I'm not dead!
Papa, we know you're not dead!
Yes, we were trying to play a joke on you!
You were playing a joke on me!
Yes, you've been so unreasonable!
So we thought it'd be hilarious!
Well,
it was!
So all the things that you said about dowries and getting married were all jokes!
Only if you want to deal with the legal fees.
The legal fees?
Legal fees?
Your daughters are threatening action. The legal fees alone could bury you.
So, I must say that I think that we can all just keep going with what you guys agree to, and it'll all be okay. Yeah, I forgive you.
Oh, Papa!
Family moment. Papa, you're the only father I've ever had. Please don't die. Please don't die.
Okay.
Not anytime soon.
Let's go to rebuild those windmills.
Oh, indeed. Windmills.
Let's go to the marketplace and find you another beautiful dress and both of us some shoes.
Oh, I love dresses and shoes.
Oh.
Your whole family thought you were dead!
Was that your doing?
Maybe.
Yes, from what I hear, you have quite your finger on the pulse of the town. You know everything that goes on. So perhaps you can come work for me, and I will profit from all of this.
Plan Omega, and go!
Oh. Fine, Olivia. Take me to the library. I want to show you so many things. Oh.
Master! Master! Oh, let's go to Spain and kill those windmills!
Drake of the Middle Kingdom, I perform with E. Scandali.
Lady Edica O'Ferry, I'm from Applemark, and I'm with E. Verdi Confusi and Il Titolo Provisorio.
Lord Derek Lagarde from North Atlantia, Maryland, and part of Gondo Soul.
Lady Avelina del Dolce from Northern Atlantia, Capi Comico, Vaganda Stolti.
I am Tristan Le Chanticleer of the East Kingdom of the All-Stars, I guess. This is my first production.
I'm Sophia the Orange, and I'm from the Barony of Windmaster's Hill in Atlantia. Atlantia, we really like Atlantia. And I'm with E. Ferenzi, and I'd like to say a super massive amount of thanks to Lucetta Di Cosimo for writing our scenario for us.
For running the Commedia track here at Pennsic. We have one more big Climedia.
There's a shop
there. That was more.
It's infectious.
One more Commedia climax for you here at Pennsic. The Youth Commedia program has its show tomorrow at 5 o'clock. You do not want to miss that, because those kids have been working all week with Kale and with Monica. They are going to show you a wonderful show at 5 o'clock
tomorrow. Where are
we? Right here. And do we have any of the kids here today? All right, there we go. Tomorrow. Thank you for coming. Take classes, learn more Commedia, and come back next year. Thank you so much.